All right, so show that for all distinct ABC is greater than or equal to zero, a squared over b minus c squared plus b squared over c minus a squared plus c squared over a minus b squared is strictly greater than two. So for those of you who have been watching my channel for a while, I actually made a video on this earlier, but I included a really simple solution. Now my solution was to notice that as c approaches zero, this is minimized. And so we can apply AMGM to a squared over b squared plus b squared over a squared is strictly greater than two, and then cancel out the equality case by assuming that a, b are distinct. So in this video, I'm gonna show you a different solution. One that's a little bit more complete, you could say. And so applying contradicts to this equation will then give us a squared over b minus c squared plus b squared over c minus a squared plus c squared over a minus b squared. All of this times 1 plus 1 plus 1 is strictly greater than, since a, b, and c are unique, a over b minus c plus b over c minus a plus c over a minus b, all squared. Now, we are also trying to prove that this is greater than 2. And so now it will suffice to show that a over b minus c plus b over c minus a plus c over a minus b, all squared is greater than 2. So testing out any values for a, b, and c will immediately show that this is negative. And so instead of assuming that this is greater than root 2, we actually assume that this is lesser than negative root 2. And so we have a over b minus c plus b over c minus a plus c over a minus b is strictly lesser than negative root 2. But actually, we want to move the equality sign the other way. So we're actually going to prove this by contradiction. So for a contradiction, we then change the sign of the inequality. Now to prove this, it will suffice to show that this is greater than negative 3 over 2. So now I'm going to move this to the top and then introduce some new terms. So first I want to prove Nesbitt's inequality. So Nesbitt's inequality states that a over b plus c plus b over c plus a plus c over a plus b is greater than or equal to 3 over 2 for all positive integers a, b, and c. Now this can be shown with type 2's lemma. So we have a squared over ab plus ac plus b squared over bc plus ab plus c squared over ac plus bc is greater than or equal to 3 over 2. Now applying type 2's lemma will then give us that this is greater than or equal to a plus b plus c all squared over 2 times ab plus ac plus bc. And so it will suffice to show that this is greater than or equal to 3 over 2. And now canceling out the 2's will then give us that this is greater than or equal to 3. So now all that's left to show is that a plus b plus c squared is greater than or equal to 3ab plus 3ac plus 3bc. And so now expanding and combining like terms will then give us a squared plus b squared plus c squared is greater than or equal to ab plus ac plus bc. Now this is very easy to show. We can multiply both sides by 2 and then rearrange the terms to get a minus b all squared plus b minus c all squared plus a minus c all squared is greater than or equal to 0, which is obviously true because all squares must be greater than or equal to 0. And so we've proven Nesbitt's inequality. Now the reason for this is I want to show that this is also greater than negative a over b plus c minus b over c plus a minus c over a plus b. And so now it will suffice to show that a over b minus c plus b over c minus a plus c over a minus b is greater than or equal to negative a over b plus c minus b over c plus a minus c over a plus b. And so now moving these terms over will then give us a over b minus c plus a over b plus c plus b over c minus a plus b over c plus a plus c over a minus b plus c over a plus b is greater than or equal to 0. And so now combining these two, and these two will then give us 2ab over b squared minus c squared plus 2bc over c squared minus a squared plus 2ac over a squared minus b squared is greater than or equal to 0. And so now we can cancel out a 2 from all three of these terms since the other side is just equal to 0. Now next, we actually want to use AMHM, or the arithmetic mean harmonic mean. So we know that this is greater than or equal to 9 over b squared minus c squared over ab plus c squared minus a squared over bc plus a squared minus b squared over ac. Now we want to prove that this is greater than or equal to 0. Now looking at this term, notice that this fraction is greater than or equal to 0 if and only if the denominator is positive. And so now all that's left to show in our contradiction is that this is greater than 0. Now, you can test out terms here to see that this is never true. But to finish off our proof, we have to set a common denominator. So we have cb squared minus c cubed plus ac squared minus a cubed plus a squared b minus b cubed is greater than 0. Since a, b, and c are positive, we multiply both sides by abc to get the same equation. And so now moving all the cubes to this side will then give us a squared b plus b squared c plus ac squared is greater than a cubed plus b cubed plus c cubed. But now we are going to contradict our contradiction, because we can show that actually this is smaller than a cubed plus b cubed plus c cubed. And so now we can use AMGM to prove this. Let's set up the following three equations. A cubed plus b cubed plus b cubed plus c cubed, and c cubed plus c cubed plus a cubed. Now applying AMGM to all three, now the first equation will give us that this is greater than 3a squared b, this is greater than 3b squared c, and this is greater than 3c squared a. So now adding all these terms together will give us 3a cubed plus 3b cubed plus 3c cubed is greater than or equal to a squared b plus b squared c plus c squared a, all multiplied by 3. So now factoring out a 3 out of all these terms will then give us the above inequality. And so now we have contradicted our contradiction, and we have proven the above statements, and we are done. Alright, thanks for watching, hopefully you've enjoyed, and hopefully I'll see you next time.